Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in last lecture we have seen inheritance and containment. Now in this lecture we are going to see polymorphism. This is the fourth paradigm of object-oriented programming. So, polymorphism, the name itself says it is a combination of two words, poly. Poly means many and morph means forms. Okay, so many forms. Little bit confusing. Let's see what actually it means. It is nothing but an different types of object, different hierarchy of a object reacts in a different way to the same message given to it. Okay, little bit confusing. So what is it? Let's take an example. Okay, now we are having different types of a car in this which runs on a road. Okay, I can say each car which is different, each car is different object, and each car is having different way or different mechanism built inside it to do some task. Okay, so I can say that if I want to change the gear, okay, so each car may be having internally different way to do the same. If I want to stop a car, each car is having different way to do inside, different mechanism to do the same. Okay, now let's say I'm having a signal. Okay, now this signal, just take a situation like this. Each car understand different signals. Okay, so if I want to stop a particular car, I have to put down one signal for that particular type of a car. Let's say for BMW, I'm having a different signal system. Okay, so whenever I want to stop BMW, I have to provide some message. Okay, if I want to start it, I have to give a different message. Okay, similar way for nano, I'm having different signal system. If let's say I'm having the Mercedes, I'm having different signaling system. Now just imagine the roads of India, what will happen to them? There will be thousands of signals over there, and you have to check out which one is mine. I'm using Mercedes, so which one is mine? And I have to check out signal, right? And when that signal comes, then I have to start and stop. Really, can it be possible? No, it won't be possible, right? First of all, we don't have that much space. Okay, now second problem is, suppose if I'm adding new car, I'm launching new car, I have to launch for signal for that car, right? So extensibility is kind of a difficult for it. Maintainability is also difficult for it. So to avoid it, what I have provided, single messaging system, signal, and that whenever that signal comes, all cars, okay, well, whether they are having different behavior, but they can stop at that particular time. If I'm providing a stop signal, all of them will stop. That means they are understanding the single message. Internally, they may have different mechanism to stop, but they can react in the same way, right? That is, all of them going to stop. Okay, because of it, what we are achieving, because of it, many objects, okay, we can able to maintain them, right? We don't have to worry about different signal systems in that case. Second thing, I can have a new addition or removal of the existing also. For that, there is no headache. Okay, because signal system will remain same, message will remain same. Any addition to that or removal of the any existing object doesn't affect rest of the thing, right? So that is nothing but a polymorphism all about. So I can say I'm having different types of a object like BMW, i10, Nano, and I'm providing a single signal system that like stop, and all of them internally may behave differently but react in the same way, that is nothing but they will stop at that particular point. Okay, through polymorphism, what I'm achieving? I'm achieving it's a maintainability, okay, as well as I'm achieving extensibility. Okay, so that is nothing but a polymorphism. Many different types of object react in the same way to the message. Okay, but internally they may behave differently. Okay, so that is nothing but a polymorphism all about. Thank you.